Welcome to Game 4 for the undefeated Reading Rockets. The boys faced the toughest test. Faced their toughest test last week with a hard-fought 18-8 victory over Wakefield, a game that was just 12-8 with about a minute to go. And this week doesn't look to get much easier as they face an also undefeated Drake team. Drake beat up on Lowell and pounded their common opponent Westford, as the Rockets did. So look for this one to be a big test. It may be an even bigger test than anticipated because the Rockets are going to be out without two key players this week, both Stephen Webb and Dante Barboza, going through concussion protocol. Those are two of the best athletes on our team, and they're big parts of the Rockets' success early on. So there's going to be some big play required out of some key players to pick up the slack and look for guys like Patrick Harrigan and Jeremy Roche to be called upon, as well as Dan Damari and Lucas Fleming to take over a little bit more. So before we get started here, we got a little bit of an early start, so they're doing a weigh-in. And, of course, there's the 34-strong Reading Rocket team here, and we'll be back in a sec. Hey, Brian, while we're getting started, a little bit early start, we're going to get right into our player profiles this week. Number 9 is Giancarlo Musto. What a name, huh, buddy? It's like he's like Italian royalty or something with that name. We caught Giancarlo doing the worm on the film last year, so we can confirm he's got the moves, right? His favorite male celebrity is Tom Brady, and his favorite food is lobster. Huh? Highfalutin taste for the worm there, right? Hey, little known fact on lobster, Bri, they keep growing forever. Sort of like most of the Rocket coaching staff, the Goon Squad, as we coined them last year, right? And actually, here's another thing about lobsters. They taste with their legs. How about that? They have chemosensory leg and feet here for tasting. Maybe Giancarlo does too. That's why he's constantly throwing himself on the ground doing the worm, right? Can you imagine the Rocket coaching staff having a worm contest? Size of those guys? What would that register on the Richter scale, Bri, huh? Awesome. Giancarlo says the animal he most liked to be, a dog. Just dog. Not any particular dog, you know? I wonder if you want to be one of those dogs, those little ones they fit in your purse. I don't even call those a dog, right? You know, they fit in their purse, they shake all the time. You know, the dogs that make you nervous. I don't know. Who wants one of those dogs? Well, anyway, hey, number 9 is Musto. And it's great to have a little extra time here to start because we can get some player profiles in. This is going to be an awesome game tonight, Bri. So we'll get started shortly. All right, set for the kickoff here. The Rockets, I believe, won and deferred. So Lucas Fleming is going to kick off and give that big defensive line their first test against a very good team. Nice kick by Lucas. It's a live ball right there. Oh, it runs out of bounds, number 13. Right around the 31-yard line. So Drakett is going to take over here. First and 10 from their own 31. It's first and 10 here for... It's this big stacked formation. They're shifting them around right now. Nice play in the middle there. I was watching that middle. That, you know, the Rockets defense shifted, and they see where they stack. They move Fleming to the outside, move Sean Beckenhuis over the center. So nice job there. This Drakett team's been known to just stack this formation and make you guess appropriately. There's some big boys on that team too. So this is going to be a great test to start here, and it's going to be second at about 7. Once again, that tight stacked formation. Oki and Fleming switch left. It looks like a keeper right. Oh, nice play right there to get in there. Oh, he's still on his feet, though. The Rockets got to make that early tackle, but they got some great pressure in there from Oki, and number 21, Richmond, was in there. Even Sean Beckenhuis got through, but they could have wrapped him up for what was a big loss, and the kid does a nice job to get a gain out of it. It's going to be third and about 3 here. This is a huge play early on. Let's go. They're going to shift right now. Here we go. 3rd and 3, big play here. It's a keeper right here. Oh, it gets through again. Number 24, nice play. He's going to get the first and more. Gets ripped down from behind by number 11, Jeremy Roche. So, you know, it's a tough play with that stack formation. They sort of have you guessing on who's going to grab it each play. But Drakett does get the first down close to midfield here. So it's going to be first and 10 at their own 48. Here we go, first and 10 for Drakett. We see the line shift again. Fleming go to the end. Oki switches the other tackle. They go against their big lineman on that side. This one's a keeper right at the middle. Oh, met almost immediately by Sean Beckenhuis. And in comes number 53. The ball's on the ground. They're saying they got it. Oh, you're saying they're down, though. Beautiful play by Beckenhuyzen. Number 53, Stephen Needham, came in and put a lick on him. So I'll say no gain there, but that ball went on the ground. The ref said he was down, so it's going to be second and 10 here. Here we go, second and call at 9.5 here. Tightly stacked formation. Straker team makes you guess who gets the ball. One person in motion. It's a keeper right up the middle, and he's got room. Wow, nice play by Jeremy Rosh to come in and close it, but no one picked up right off the middle, and the quarterback keeps it for about 8 yards, very close to the first down here. Rockets would like to have one of these pushbacks right here. They get in the backfield a couple of times and couldn't wrap them up. It's a big play here, third and short. Different formation here, I formation. It's a keeper right up the middle. They're giving it to him, number 12, and he's taking it. So nice job right over the center. He sees the opening and gets the first down. So different formation for Drake, and they take it for the first down. So they're moving the ball well here in their first set. It's a big defensive line challenge for Rockets right now. First and 10 here for Drake after a couple of first downs early on. This one's in the shotgun right here. It's a keeper left for number 12. Nice play. Oh, Patrick Harrigan, he almost had him there, and he gets around him. So great play for number 12, gets around Harrigan. And those are the guys we talked about early on, that the guys like Harrigan and Pollock and Rosh are going to have to come up big here. And number 12 was just speedy enough to get around him for another first down. So inside the 30-yard line here, it's going to be another first for Drakett. First and 10 here for Drakett. See almost no one back, just expecting the run. And it is a keeper. Number 41's right up the middle. Great play by, look like, Damari to tackle Lamar. No, it was Danny Damari. A little bit of help from Patrick Harrigan, but he rips off five easy. Second and five here for Drakett. They've been taking advantage of that middle. If it's open, they've been taking it. Now they did a big split left here, like they got passes. Set up for a pass. He is going to go back for a pass. Big rush right here. He throws it. Hits his hands and drops it. So Jeremy Rosh was right there to lay a lick on him, and Keith Richmond was too. So looking for a little bit of trickery here on second down with the pass, with the guys in motion, three guys, and Redding was set for it. Hey, big third down play here for the Rockets. We're probably in four down territory here. The Rockets trying to line up here where they're stacked heavy. It's a cut right here. Oh, right in there is number 21, Richmond. So they do stop him short, a couple yards short, but look for definite four down territory here. So it's going to be fourth and two, and this is going to be a huge play early in the game for this Rocket D. Going to need a big push right here. This is a very big play here for the Rockets. They go back to that familiar stack tight offense. The Rockets got to get a big push here. Look for the quarterback to keep it. Oh, he hikes it. Oh, they get ripped up, and they don't get it, I don't think. Right in there was Oki, and in there is number 11, Jeremy Rosh, to stack it. I think the Rockets are going to get this ball. Yes, I think so. Beautiful play by the defense there. So I think Danny O'Connor and Jeremy Rosh were in on that play, and didn't fool anyone that time, and that's a huge stop right there because Drake had a great first series there, and good thing the Rockets adjusted. I don't know about that play call, second and five, throwing a pass right there, Brian. They put him in a third and five situation, and maybe not the play call Drake had needed right there, but let's see what the Rockets get in their first time. Lucas Fleming and Sean Beckenhuyzen in the backfield. It's a keeper for Fleming. Oh, he's got a little bit of room. Oh, boy, did you see Lucas right there? He could have cut up the field. He said, I wanted to give number 12 a hey, hello, I'm number 24. I'm two times you. How about that? What a play by Fleming. He takes it off of four, maybe five hard yards, and number 12 is saying, wow, who is that kid? I think Fleming could have taken two more yards here. He decided to say hello to their number 12. Lucas again, low snap, does a good job to get around there, but it's a good job right there by, oh, Lucas drives it for a gain where there was none, so he gets another yard or two, and it's going to be third and call it four here coming up. quarterback right now. We have Fleming, and it looks like Beckenhuis behind him in the eye. Look for Fleming to go behind Beckenhuis. That's what he does, and Fleming gets wrapped up almost immediately. Oh, he's still on his feet, though. Lucas drives it for another yard or two. But nice job by Drakett's defense there. It's going to be fourth and probably two here, and this is a tough situation right here, 30-yard line. You may want to see someone booting this ball. They may be kicking this thing as Fleming is backed up a little bit here. Look for Fleming to maybe kick this one away. Snap's important here. Yep. Oh, it's not a great kick. Let's hope they get a good bounce. It's not a great bounce, but only a net gain of about, maybe 12 yards there as Lucas popped it up more in the air than instead of driving it. So it is a turnover on downs here for the Rockets, and Drakett's going to take over first and 10 from the Rocket 40. So maybe not put themselves in the best position on that one. Lucas would like to have that one back, I'm sure. Hey, number 40 is Matt Sagala. Matt Sagala's favorite food, cheeseburgers. We have another Taylor Swift fan here at BVH. As you know, I dabble in songwriting, BVH. Oh, yeah. And I will say that Taylor Swift, she has the chops. Hey, fun fact about Taylor Swift, she was actually born in Reading. Yeah, unfortunately, it's Reading, Pennsylvania. But now it says that Matt wanted to be, I'll come back to Matt in a sec, as we start here on the change of the quarter. Is the Rockets shifting to match up with that stacked right formation? It's a snap, it's on the ground right there, and oh boy! Nice job by Sean Beckenhuis and Steven Needham in there, but Fleming was coming in, and that guy might want to go down again. So the snap is low. It's going to push him back a little bit. Getting back to Sagala, he actually said he'd like to be an eagle, right? The American bald eagle makes a nest is 13 feet deep and 8 feet wide and can weigh 1 ton. Really? How about that, huh? Oh, nice. Coach Damari has a similar-sized hammock in his backyard. Yeah, which, of course, when he's resting in it, actually weighs 2 tons. So Matt's dad is Deputy Police Chief Mark Sagala. We'll have to get him on camera later. Love to give Mark a little bit of grief, but not too much grief, if you know what I mean, huh? So it looks like we're going to come back here. It's going to be second and 13 here with a timeout for Drakett. Here we go. Call it second and 13 here for Drakett. Similar formation. See who's going to get the ball, right? It's a direct snap. It's a reverse right here. He's got a little bit of room, number four. In comes Patrick Harrigan to drive him out. So right over there was Andrew Fortino, too. So nice job by those guys. It looks like they picked up maybe three or four, but it's going to be third and long coming up. So a little bit of trickery they add to their mix here for Drakett. And this is a big play right here from the 37 coming up. All right, here we go. They're going to shift right now. Fleming and O'Connor switch to the outside to go against the big guys. Direct snap to number 24. He follows a block right there. Good play and a cutback, but what a play by Jeremy Rosh. Jeremy came in and closed it and rips him down at the 35-yard line. So, and he was the last line of defense, too. So great job by Jeremy there, looking like his counterpart, Danny Damari. So huge play. We told you we needed something big out of Jeremy to make this happen. This is fourth and five here. Probably going to go for it at the 35-yard line. But last time the Rocket D came up big, let's see if they can do it again. Here we go, fourth and five here. Rockets shifting again. This one goes right to 24 again. He tries to get outside. He may have it, but oh, he gets hit hard. And I think he gets hit short too. That's Rosh. That is Rosh again. And number, let's see who else was with him. Keith Richmond. I think they stopped him. This is going to be a turnover on downs again. Beautiful play right there. Number 24 looked like he had something. In came Jeremy and Keith Richmond to push him out. So two huge fourth down stops here. Let's see if the second time the Rockets get the ball, they can get something going here. With 8:18 to go in the second, it's a very tightly played 0-0 ball game. Here we go. First and 10 here for the Rockets. It's Troy Polak and Dan Demary in the backfield now. Split way right, DVH. Couple guys split left. In motion is Sagala. And it's going to be a follow right behind there. Nice cutback by Troy, and Troy takes it for a quick five, maybe six. So good-looking play in a big hole right there. So Rockets getting a little bit of momentum on first down here. That's a nice play to start it. Call it second and just under five here, 4.5. Demary and Polak again, same formation, just two split right this time. In motion the other way is Sagala. Now it's going to be a keeper this way. Troy goes right at the middle, and he takes it for four. It's going to be third and about a foot, maybe a yard or so. But Troy saw an opening and took it. It's going to be third and short coming up. All right, not the greatest spot right there for Troy. I think he went a little bit farther than that 40-yard line, but it's third and short here. We got a flag right now. They're saying someone moved. Oh, gosh. This guy threw about 74 flags in the C game, and they're saying that there's motion right now, and Bob Junta is apoplectic over there saying, you have to be kidding me. Huge play right there, and they call a motion play. That is outrageous, and Junta is furious, and he should be. Wow, that is an unbelievable call with third and one here that's going to push the Rockets back now to third and six. Under center is Polak. Sagala and Demary behind him. It's going to be a pass to Polak. He's right out there, and there's Jeremy Rosh, and Jeremy cuts up. Come on, Jeremy. Get in there. Doing a little homers and cheering right there. See how he gets it, but it's going to be very close to the first down. He may have it. He's right there. This guy's set up there, and let's see where this spot is. First down. Beautiful play by Jeremy. I totally turned into a homer right there, huh, cheering for Jeremy there on the play? So much for objectivity, BBH. But great play right there. Great play call, and Jeremy was wide open. He's athletic enough to push it for a few more. A huge first down. I tell you, we saw that ref in the earlier game. He threw about 17 flags here. Boy's a 12-year-old. Oh, boy, great athletic play by Danny Demary just to hold on to that ball. He does take it for a loss, but way over his head, and he skied for it. And it's going to be a pushback for the Rockets, unfortunately, but that could have been a lot worse if not for the play by Demary. Huge athletic play to save maybe a massive problem right there. So it's going to be second and call it 17 right here for the Rockets. Here we go, second and 17. We have Demary behind Sagala. It's a handoff to Danny. He's got a big hole. Oh, he cuts up and bowls forward, puts his shoulder down, rips off about 10, maybe 9, and it's going to be third and 7 here coming up. But a great play by Dan. I think our running backs are dying to put their shoulders in the guys' heads. Maybe if they looked up a little left and right, they might have a little bit more running room ahead of them. But great cutback by Dan. That's a big gain. They're going to need another one right here at midfield to keep this drive going. Same setup, I formation, stacked heavy left. It's a handoff to Demary. He gets met almost immediately. So he's following big number 72, Andrew Hattery, and he only gets about a yard here, and it's going to be fourth and let's say six here from midfield. This is going to be a very interesting call for Coach Junta. Looks like the Rockets are going to go for it here. So maybe with the tough wind up there and they saw with the last kick netted, they're going to stay with it. It's a keeper to Polak. Polak throws it up. He sends the same play to Jeremy, and he holds on to the ball for a first down. What a play by Rosh. Same setup play, beautiful, and Jeremy takes a huge stick and holds on to the ball. So we talked about other players stepping up for Webb and Barboza, and Jeremy Rosh has done exactly that early in the game, and that's a huge first down for the Rockets. Patrick Harrigan in right now with back to the big guys, Beckenhuis and Fleming. It's a handoff to Fleming right behind Sean. Oh, look at the hole. My gosh, he takes it for about 9 or 10. And he sees some of those little guys, 87 and 12, saw Fleming. 12 was introduced to Fleming on the first play of the game, offensive play of the game, and it looks like it's very close to a first. If not, it's going to be inches. Second and one here for the Rockets. Same setup. Look for Fleming again behind Beckenhuis. And there it is. Lucas has the first down and more. Oh, he doesn't want to go down. He takes it for about 6 or 7. And he's a tough guy to bring down. So it's going to be first and 10 for the Rockets at the 30. And that's a good start after that Great fourth down conversion from Pollock to Rosh. First and 10 here for the Rockets, 31-yard line. Same I formation. Why not stay with the same thing? It's working. And they do. Fleming pushes it forward for an easy five. So nice job here with about 3 minutes, over 3 minutes to go in the half. The Rockets would love to get in the board because they know they're getting the ball back, a la the Patriots, right, BVH? So this is awesome. Hey, listen, while we're waiting for this flag to come in, I mentioned last week Patrick DeRoss. He said that what he really wanted to put his favorite place to visit, it wasn't New Hampshire. It was the fridge. I talked to Paul and Mary. They're like, oh, my God, I got four boys. It's like the Damari family coming up again. $600 food bills. Here is Patrick Harrigan underneath. It's a keeper for Patrick. He's going to follow Lucas this time. Oh, no, the ball's on the ground. Just hop on this thing. Just hop on it. Oh, I think he got pushed out of the way there, and it looks like the ball is turned over. Oh, boy. Trev Conroy was right there and got pushed out of the way, and it's a turnover here. So terrible series of events right there. The ball gets lost. They were trying to follow Fleming, and a couple of the big guys came through, knocked the ball loose. And we're talking about trying to score before the half. And in one play, now we got to talk about trying to prevent the score before the half. In this play, but you got to stay close to him. First and 10 here for Drake it after the fumble. And that's a killer right there. It's a direct snap, number 24. He gets wrapped up and pulled down. Nice job right there. It was number 24 was Fleming, and Oki helped him out too. So Fleming grabs him by the leg. He only gets 1 yard. So they've been going to that play 24 quite a bit, and it goes nowhere on first down. Okay, second and 9.5 right here. Direct snap to 24 again. Oh, he's going to pull back and maybe throw the ball. Oh, he's got pressure on him now. Let's see if they can close. Oh, boy, what a stick right there by Damari. And that was they were looking to pass. Great pass coverage back there by Rosh and Damari and Pollock. Rosh Harrigan and Pollock. And he almost got blown up for a big loss. So credit number 24 just to get back to the line of scrimmage there. But he took a lick from Damari for doing it. So it's third and long here right now. And this is one that the Rockets would love to have with another pushback with only a minute and 23 seconds ticking off the clock. All right, looks like they're saying there's only 30 seconds to go and a half. It's third and very long here. Different setup here. They're going to be looking to pass, clearly. It's a low snap. Oh, boy, look at this. Heaves up in the air. Go for the ball here, boys. Come on, Troy. Troy intercepts it. Get himself out of bounds. He may have a lot of room in front of him. Troy's going to keep going. He cuts in, cuts back out. So interception by Pollock here. Heaves up a duck on the double pass play, getting a little too cute, and the Rockets might have a little bit of time here from the 30. So great play by Troy right there to pick up the pass. Unfortunately for the Drake players, situation, the wind is very tough here too. Not the greatest time to be throwing long bombs here, but look at the smile on Adam Pollock's face. He's thrilled. Talk about peacocking, huh? His boy just made a couple of great play conversions on four. Oh boy, what another flag here. What are they calling it on? Let's see. Gosh, he's calling hitting from behind on Redding. Nope, he's calling on them. March off another 15. All right, couple of turnovers late here in the half. Let's see if the Rockets, just not a lot of time here in the half. Let's see if they get something going. This is going to be passed from Troy. Oh, boy. Wow. Great play for Troy just to hold on to that, but there were three or four Drake players all over him. Couldn't set up that play we've seen a couple times before, but that gets pushed way back, and it's going to be probably a loss of more than 10 there, but good play by Troy just to pull the ball in and hold on to it. Looks like there's only 5 seconds left here. Time for one more play, and Drake's defense is set up that way, playing very far back here. Patrick Harrigan in the shotgun. He fakes it here, and Patrick's going to heave it up. It's a little bit underthrown there and drops in incomplete, and I think that's probably going to be the half here. So it looks like it's the half, and they, what a tightly fought game here. A couple of turnovers at the end. The game's mostly been played between the 30-yard line here. We haven't seen much, certainly no red zone play here, but coming up to the half, it is Reading 0, Drake at 0. Hey, back to our segment, BVH, the Coaches Answer the Kids Survey. This week's coach, the big double D himself, Daniel Anthony Damari. Hey, that says dad, huh? All right. We have a lot of fun with the Big D, mostly due to his gargantuan size and grizzly bear-like eating habits, but here goes, right? His favorite food, anything Nana makes. He's another big Gronk fan, too. And Coach Dan says his favorite movie is Gladiator. Remember that one, BVH? Yeah. Huh? Russell Crowe is Maximus. Yeah. Wouldn't it be cool if Coach D, like, he should have a name like Maximus, huh, Coach D? Famous quote from Gladiator, what we do in life echoes in eternity, huh? Could you imagine if your eternal legacy was I ate more meatballs than any person on earth? How about that for Coach D? Hey, remember we talked about Coach Junta reading books about string theory? Yep. Yeah, Coach Damari thought string theory was about angel hair pasta. Yeah, true story. Hey, fun fact about Coach Damari, too. He can actually hold the entire Pollock family in the palm of his hand. Didn't know that. Well, listen, Coach D might be in the running for nicest guy in Reading. Yeah, I don't know. Who else is up there? Roger Krupa, he's pretty nice. But listen, since Roger's kid isn't playing football anymore, then we got to go with Coach D for that one. He's talk about a giant teddy bear. You know what he said the word for him was to describe him? Caring. Yeah. I'm getting a little misty up here. Wow, I want to go give that big grizzly bear a hug right now. Hey, at halftime, and this is a really, really great game right here, defensive battle. It is 0-0. We'll be back. All right, looks like the Rockets are going to get set to get the ball back here with Troy Pollock and Dan Damari back deep. We've seen Barboza. It's a great kick. Wow, Danny's got to grab that thing, and he does right around the 15-yard line. Nice little cutback there, but he gets stopped right about the 25. So good run back for Dan to get about 11 yards back, and the Rockets are going to take over from their own 25. Here go the Rockets, first and 10, call it from the 27-yard line. Nice job by Dan to gain something out of a very good kick. Fortunate bounce for Drake. It's a direct snap to Fleming. He falls, hits number 41 very hard, gets stopped for a short gain. So nice job right there at number 41, though. There looked like the helmets might have been hooked at one point. So here comes Fleming for the second down play. Here we go, second and call it 8 right now. Beckenhuis and Fleming in the backfield. Direct snap to Fleming. Oh, Lucas takes it outside, but he gets tripped up. And nice job by the D. They actually push him back for a loss on this one. So good job by the Drake at D to string it out. Drake's got some big boys on that team over there too, right? Number 13's a big guy over there on the right side. Number 41 too. So they get some big plays. It's third and long here, and this is going to be a very big play coming up for the Rockets. Big play right here for the Rockets, third and 10. It goes, it's a low snap. Inside handoff to Jeremy Rosh, and Jeremy cuts it. He's still on his feet. Wow, Jeremy's got some very, very tough runs today, and he's very close to the first down there. So he's come up huge offensively, too, for Reading. Jeremy is stepping up when needed, and you're probably getting some more playing time for the sake of they gave him the first down again. Wow, that is awesome. That's three huge first downs for Jeremy. So that's a big play right there, and maybe a fortunate spot on Reading's side for that one, Bri. We'll take it. We can be homers, right, for the 25 people that watch this broadcast? Why not? First and 10 here. Fleming. Oh, it's actually Dan Damari. Damari cuts up and gets a little something out of nothing and takes it for about 3 or 4. Right about the 40-yard line, and in comes a whole new offense right now. I formation right here, Damari's back. Pollock under center, hand off to Dan. Oh, he follows Matt Sagala. And he takes it for about another three or four here. So it's going to be right about 45-yard line. Let's say it's going to be third and three coming up. Big play right here, right around midfield. Third and call it a little long two here. Beck and Houston Damari in the I formation. It's a handoff to Danny up the middle. He drives it for the first down. Nice play by Dan. Follows number 44 offensive line, Danny Junta, coach's son. So that's a big first down around midfield for the Rockets. First down for Redding, just inside the 50-yard line. Pollock hands off to Damari again. Danny gets pulled back from behind, and he gets stacked up for a short gain. Call it two here, and it's going to be second and eight coming up. Fleming comes in for Damari behind Beckenhuis. Steady dose of Lucas has been working today, so let's keep with it. And there it is. Oh, boy, he puts his head down there, rips it off for about 5 yards, and it's going to be third and three coming up. So nice run by Lucas. It's third and a long three here. Let's do what's working, right? How about right back to Fleming? He's telling Beckenhuis to do something right now. A little change at the line here. Handoff right up the middle. Oh, nice cutback by Lucas. He's going to have the first down, I think. If not, he's going to be inches short. But tell you, the big man with a little cutback, he can move too. And that's a nice job. He's very close to the first. If not that, it might be inches. He may call it third and inches. Or fourth and a first down. Beautiful. First down again, so that's a huge first down here for the Rockets at their 41-yard line. So it's working. Let's stay with it, right? All right, here we go. First down here. We got Damari behind Beckenhuis now. Pollock under center. Oh, the ball's on the ground. It was dropped immediately. Didn't even get the handoff, and it gets pounced on by Draken. So I don't even think Dan Damari had his hands on that ball. It was a tough snap in the exchange. They missed it, and Draken pounces on it. So Redding finally gets some momentum. They turn the ball over again. First and 10 here for Draken. Wow, the penalties hurting the Rockets here in these turnovers when they start getting a little bit of momentum. Fortunate bounces for Draken. Handoff right at the middle. And, oh, Lucas Fleming comes in and croaks him as he's moving around on the D, too. And Andrew Hattery in there as well, number 53. Oh, sorry, Stephen Needham, 53. And I think Hattery might have had 53 or 52 last year. That's how my unbelievable memory works there, Bry. But nice pushback by Lucas. And in the standard format here, Lucas is going to be a very tough guy over the center to stop. So you might see him go back to that stack formation, but it's second and now let's call it 11. And you do see it, that same formation. Who's it going to go to? Where's the direct snap? Look for number 24. 24, it's a keeper right. They try to go around, and Andrew Fortino gives a push, and then he gets pushed out by, looks like, number 15, Harrigan. But he does gain about maybe six or seven, and that's a different play. That's a play that they're obviously calling in the field to say, let's go weak side that time instead of strong side. And number 24 turns it into a big gain, and it's going to be third and four coming up. All right, third and three here. This is a big play right here for the Rockets. They line up their D right here. Beckenhuis might be over the ball there if they throw a flag. It's a keeper for 24, and he looks like he's going to have the first down. Yes, he definitely does now. He gets pulled down from behind by, let's see, number 54, Oki, and number 41, Sean Beckenhuis, but they're going to have the first here. So good play by Draken over midfield, and they have a first down. All right, first and 15 here. Pushes it back over to the Draken side of the field. Different formation here. It's a keeper right up the middle. Oh, nice job to avoid it, but in comes Damari and closes the door quickly. So stops him after a short gain. I think that might have been something that a quarterback saw for himself and took it, but Damari closed the door quickly. Beck, so it's going to be second and call a 12 coming up right from midfield. Here we go. Second and 12 here. Coming up. It's a keeper left. Oh, he got some pressure immediately. Oh, nice job by Andrew Fortino to close there. And looks like Zach Kenyon in there and Oki as well. So they stop him short here. It's going to be, look like, third and very long here. Nice job by the D here. Find Oki, 54. He's right here. Hey, number 54 player profile right now. Near and dear to my heart, Dan O'Connor, right? I brought Dan in the mix this week because he's actually turning 13 years old on Friday, huh? So I wanted to tell him happy birthday and that I love him, right? Hey, I'm not afraid to wear my heart on my sleeve. Am I, Patty B?
Never, huh? Oak. Never.
Big guys being vulnerable. Chicks love that, I heard. Listen, Dan loves cheeseburgers. His favorite male celebrity, J.J. Watt. He's a beast, right?
Yeah.
Maybe we could bring Oak in on that goal line package, send him out for a pass, right? So, let's see, Dan's favorite movie, Gran Torino. What a great movie, huh?
Gran Torino?
Yeah, it's pretty heady stuff, isn't it? Yeah.
Big time.
What parent is letting their kid watch Gran Torino? I think he's 13, not 17, but I'm going to have to talk to his mother about that. But listen, for the second year running, Dan said he wanted to be a bear if he could be any animal. We were joking that Dan actually grew 5.5 inches this past year. He's more like a baby giraffe, right? Hey, look at my new legs, right? Chicago is one of Dan's favorite places to visit. Here's a little known fact. Dan's great-grandfather actually housed vehicles for the one and only Al Capone.
Wow.
True story. True story. Of course, you'll never be able to confirm that, but, but take my word, it's true. But Oki's a great kid. He's probably a better kid than football player, but he's had a heck of a year this year.
Absolutely.
He's been awesome. He had a huge plays last week. He got a big task this week. He's going against number 13, their biggest player all day. And he's had a couple of big plays early on. So, you know, like you said, whenever we can pump the tires of our own kids, people, we're going to do it. This is volunteer work. Hey, speaking of big guys, Dan's Uncle Tom is here. Guy's a monster. I get if Dan gets his size, forget about it.
Big Dan DiMari just nodded up to us here from the sidelines.
Last thing, he's giving a tip of the cap to you, PB, up here.
I think so.
Look at you, get the scally cap up here. You're freezing, get shorts. Freezing, it's about 30 degrees up here.
You notice it's the old school scally cap. It's kind of a thug scally cap back in the 20s.
I don't know, maybe if you, that's
tough guy. Hey, I'm trying to present that tough guy press.
Listen, another reference to the 1920s here, Al Capone in your hat. Wow, this is some, we're right on top of pop culture here, aren't we? All right, hey, we'll get back to the game shortly. All right, it's going to be first down here for the Rockets. Let's see who we have at quarterback. It's Troy Pollack at quarterback. So Rockets taking over. I don't know what took so long there. Oh, they're going. They're changing quarters here. So
yeah.
It's fourth quarter, 0-0 game, and it's a good one. It's going to be a keeper for Pollack. Pollack takes it himself. Let's get DiMari out in front of him. DiMari gets behind him, maybe trips him up. So I think Danny might have wanted to get ahead of him there. Have a lead blocker, but Troy wasn't to be denied. He said, get out of my way, Dan. I'll take this myself. And he gets about 5.
Spot here to get some points.
Well,
late in
listen,
the game.
Points are at a premium here. And one or two plays, clearly, in the first half, one or two plays are going to change this game. Let's hope they're in the affirmative for the Rockets. DiMari, back deep. Shotgun. Goes to Troy. Troy pitches it out to Danny. And Danny's got room. Oh, cut back. He cuts back. He's still on his feet. Oh, great play. Oh, the ball's on the ground. Let's see if the Rockets get it. If it goes the other way, we're in trouble. Oh, my gosh, the Rockets pounce on it. Oh, geez, did you see that play? Maybe if DiMari goes left. You know what? The kid always wants to cut up because he's a great cutback guy, and he'd rather hit somebody. We talked about two huge plays that can change the game. The ball goes on the ground, and this time it's fortunate for the Rockets to hold on to it. So,
who heads up jumped on that ball? That
was
a
huge
play.
Oh, my God. You know what? I couldn't see. Who do you think? Matt Sagala, huge play. I think that was Matt Sagala hopping on that ball right there. And there he is. There's his dad down there peacocking with Fortino. Well, look at him. He's high-fiving everybody in the stands over here. Oh, my God. Calm down, Dad. Your son did it, not you. Here we go. First down here. Pollack, it's a handoff right. Oh, look at this. It's a sweep to Rush out the side. Jeremy takes it out for about 10. Now 5 yards, I mean, to the 10-yard line. So nice looking play right there, and it's going to be, call it 2nd and 5 here. We're in the red zone here, and the Rockets need to make this one count.
Ball protection huge here for the Rockets. Drake has been stripping
no
all
doubt.
Day long.
Listen, they put the ball on the ground a couple of times, and Drake has hopped on, and the Rockets are fortunate that one didn't happen. We have Beckenhuis with DiMari. It's a hand. Oh, it's a keeper for Troy, and he gets around the outside.
He's
going to get in there. Oh, what a great play. Keeper for Pollock. And he gets in there, and everyone bites on it. And Troy's got the wheels to get outside. What a great play right there, and a great play call, even better, right?
Absolutely.
Haven't seen it all day. They pull that one. It looked like Fran Tarkenton or Doug Flutie out there, huh? What a play. Huge play, and the Rockets get on the board here. Now, this is a very big one here. With Stephen Webb out, we may be asking Jeremy Rosh to try to kick an extra, but the wind is very tough down here. It might be a tough one to kick.
Right to left, right in our faces.
I think Jeremy is going to set up for this, and this is huge, Patrick, because I don't know if you know about this. An extra point in Pop Warner is 2 points, not one. So you get two here, it's huge. And the kicking duty has gone to Stephen Webb the last few weeks, but Jeremy did a great job also. So if Jeremy can get this thing up and through, that'd be huge for the Rockets.
This would be big. I'd put it right at the right upright.
Here we go. Nice snap and hold, Jeremy. Oh, it gets blocked. They can't run it back in this one, but you know what? It looked like Jeremy got a good piece of it, but credit Draker for just getting through that line. The line needed a little bit of a push. I think that might have had it. He kicked it nice and hard, but once again, we talk about what can happen here, but that's a big block now too, right? But
rumor has it you work with those kickers, though. Is that true?
I did. I did work with our boy Jeremy and Stephen Watts. But let me tell you something. That wasn't his fault.
No.
I might have to. I don't want to blame anybody in general, but maybe the offensive line could have helped us, Jeremy and Troy a little bit more right there. But what a great play by Troy Pollock to get on the board here. And I'll tell you, points are at a premium. Set up by not only a huge play by Damari,
yep,
but a huge fumble recovery by Matt Sagala hopping on that. How about Eagle Eyes Van Horn up here, huh? You know what he does? There's certain things you can take that make your eyes really focus in on some things. And BVH is he's a master at that. The guy can see like 4 miles. He's like got Eagle Eyes up here. Okay, we'll come back for the kick soon. Here's Lucas Fleming to kick off. Let's see if he can get a big one here. Nice kick by Lucas. Oh, don't go out of bounds. Nice. Beautiful kick. Let's see if the Rockets can close on this guy. Oh, nice job. He curls right back.
Oh,
and he's got room in front of him. Oh, boy. What a run back. And the Rockets had perfect coverage down there. You just saw a seam and went for it. You got to talk about guys staying in the lanes right there, PB. Have to look at that one. But that would look like a beautiful kick by Fleming. Gets turned into a huge turnaround and great field position. Hey, same field position for Drake it is what Redding had in the last one. So now the Rocket D's got to come up big with 8 minutes to go in the game. All right, big series right here with the Rockets up 6-0 in the fourth. You see that defensive shift. Fleming goes outside and Okie goes on the other side against the big offensive line.
Bunch formation.
It's a keeper for 24. He gets wrapped up almost immediately. Beautiful play here. You know, this is a formation you see a lot of, PB. They put three or four guys in there and they'll hike it to any one of three guys. And it's no trickery. They let you see it and say, stop us. And I'll tell you, Drake it, who has rolled both Westford and Lowell, rolled them, are getting solved right here by the big defensive line by the Rockets. So call it 2nd and 8 right now.
There's some hard hitting going on down there. You can hear the popping up here.
All right, 2nd and 8 right here, same formation. This one's a keeper right, number 24 again. He cuts up, nice job by him. He looked like Danny DeMari right there with a cutback, but he does get stripped down by Jeremy Rosh and Troy Pollock come in. Danny DeMari there too, so it's gonna be 3rd and 4 right now, maybe a little more than 3.
Oak, I think Hurricane Joaquin just hit.
Yeah, I said you hear the popping of that. It's actually your eardrums. We're up here freezing. I feel like we're sitting on the wing of an airplane right now. This is a very big play here, 3rd and 4. It's probably 4-down territory here in the fourth quarter here, but huge play here. Oh, looks like a couple guys moving. It's a keeper for number 41. He takes it, and he got the first down and more. So that's where the trickery plays off, and that's the first time they went for a direct snap right to the guy behind him. He takes it for a first down, so at the 30-yard line here. That big run back really beneficial to Drake it. Here we go. It's 1st and 10 here for Drake it. This is like a counterpunch right here, right? This is their chance to get back with the same field position the Rockets had. Rockets had a big play to make it happen. There's a pass right here. Oh, it's underneath, and he's got room. Number 41, here comes Jeremy. Beautiful form tackle by Jeremy. Whew. He's a big dude, number 41. He made the catch out there. Jeremy came in and closed on him, and it's going to be, let's see, about third and call it four right now. All right, it's second and maybe a long three right here from the 25-yard line. We saw that play before. It was set up well. He overthrew it the first time. I formation. This is a little different. This one's going to be a pitch out to number 24. Nice job for the Rockets to string him out and just push him out of there. In comes, who's that? Number 53 was charging across right there with Steven Needham to push him out too. So short gain there. And it's going to be, what do we have, third? I don't know what we have here. Call it third down.
As you know, Oak, it's all about setting the edge on those outside plays. We need a little Bill Belichick D here. Bend but don't break and set the edge.
I think
that's how you get it done.
I think Galby said set the edge 2 weeks ago, too. You guys have obviously been over coffee at Bagel World talking about this.
If he said it, he stole it from me. There's no doubt about that.
Hey, here's that same formation. Rockets need a pushback. It's a keeper left this time. 41 keeps it again. Danny Junter gets in there, but it's going to be very close to the first down. They stack him up. Junter, number 52. Pacino in there. Number 7, Troy Pollock on the bottom of that pile, but it looks very close to the first down. They may give it to him here.
Oh, what was that? I'm going to say that they're short by an inch.
We'll see what they call here. Very close, but hey, it's four down territory
there
anyway.
It is.
Nope, they call it fourth down. Fourth and a foot here. This is a massive, massive play for this game right here. If the Rocket D would love to see something happen here. Look for that same stack formation, but no, they go back to the eye. Look for a keeper here up the middle. Huge play right here. They put Fleming over the center again. It's a ball. It's a keeper. Oh, they get stacked up, and does he get it? They say no. They say no, and if this could be a huge part of the game here, but I'm thinking they're saying yes. They gave him the first down. Wow, great job by the D, and they give him the first, though. He might have had it for forward momentum. It was close.
Yeah.
So I think it was a right call for a first down. But, hey, now it's the first time in the game that Drakett has actually been in the red zone. We'll see what they have.
Time for that big D line to step up here, Oak.
Here we go, first down here. 3 minutes left in this game. Back to that familiar trickery. Everyone stacked in tight. Direct snapped. Oh, it's an inside. It's a reverse. Good looking play. Cuts up number 4. Wow, the ball's on the ground. And there he goes. Who hops on it? Who hops on that ball? Oh, boy. This is a huge play here where he gets it. And it looks like they keep it.
Oof.
So, wow. Fortunate for Drake. That could have been the ball game right there. But a good-looking play by number 4. He gets hit. Nicely set up play. The ball gets pushed back by 3 yards. Number 18 took a big lick, and Fleming was right in there. Oki was in there as well. But Drake comes up with the ball. It says 2 minutes and counting. Unfortunately, we can't trust the clock on the field, the game clock here. We have to pay attention here. But it's going to be second and now 8 here from the, let's call it, 17-yard line. More traditional formation right now. Inside, oh, it's another reverse. Number 4, they got to get out there. This Harrigan looks like he got pushed by behind. It's Harrigan.
Oh, great
and he
tackle
gets hit.
At the one.
Oh, knocked out of the one, but.
Troy Pollock.
Troy Pollock with a huge hit to stop him. It's going to be first and goal here. And I'll tell you right now, look to me, we had to watch the tape there. Patrick Harrigan was closing. Looked like he got a little bit of a push behind him. It's going to be first and goal, and this is going to be. Oof, that fumble could have turned the things the other way, and it's going to cut. This one's going to be very, very tight here at the end. First and goal right here for Drakett. It's a keeper right up the middle of 41, and I think he's in there. Not sure. I haven't seen the signal yet. They don't give it to him. So call it second and a foot coming up.
One of those strategic situations, Oak, we almost, do you want him to score with 2 minutes left or let this clock run out on us? Wait, that ball's on the inch yard
line. That's precisely the type of commentary we're looking for. I agree with you, right? You leave some time on the clock, you let him in, but you got to stop him on that extra point no matter what.
Yes.
You have to. It's a keeper to number 24, and he does go in. So with 1:37, it says lift on the clock here, they go in. Now this is going to be a massive play right here for the extra point coming up. Now this is an absolutely massive play. 2 minute warning just called. Rockets need a big defensive push right here. Big back number 41, look for him to keep it himself. 24 is another guy, goes to 24. Oh no, Troy Pollock was there and couldn't grab him. Troy almost had him in the backfield and just couldn't get his hands on him. And number 24 runs in for the extra point. And Drake, it takes the lead 7-6. So, wow. Athletic play by Troy and just couldn't grab him. That number 24 is a good player. And Drake, it goes up 7-6 here. What a game. 2 minutes to go and the Rockets are going to get the ball back. Let's see if we can do something here.
Be nice.
20 is Keegan Lee. Last player profile before this kickoff. He's a fan of Gronk. Favorite female celebrity, Alex Morgan. USA soccer team,
yes.
That's right. We've seen a lot of Ronda Rouseys, but Alex Morgan's an athlete, huh? Keegan says he wants super speed. We'll come back to him right now. They're getting ready for the kickoff. This is a huge series for the Rockets. Nice kick by this kid right here. It's over Damari's head. He's got to get that ball. Picked up by Troy. Troy cuts back. Oh, he's got a little seam there. Let's see if he can do it. If he gets a block, he's gone. Oh, boy.
That's
great,
what he needed right there.
Great run back by Troy. That's exactly what they needed. Wow. He made a nice cutback there. He had a blocker ahead of him. Maybe if Troy waits a half a step, he might have sprung him. But, hey, when you get the ball and you see daylight, you go. So right back to midfield. That's going to be awesome field position for the Rockets. Oh, boy. This is a tight one here. It's a great one. Getting back to Keegan. He says he wanted super speed. They say Usain Bolt. Usain Bolt's the fastest man, right?
Yes.
I was reading an article. They said there are six animals faster than him. One's an ostrich. Huh? Run 40 miles an hour. How about that? His favorite food's buffalo wings, Patty B.
Oh.
Huh? How awesome is that? I love them. Who makes the best? Maybe Kitty's has good ones, too.
Kitty's really a solid buffalo
around
wings.
Here, yeah. Here we go. First and 10 for the Rockets. And this is ball game time here. Troy Pollock in the shotgun. Oh, it's a high one. He keeps it.
Ooh,
oh, he throws it
pitch
up high. It's over his head. Oh, boy. And it gets pounced on by Drake. It. Troy, last minute, tried to make a decision, actually had to throw it over someone's head. And the ball gets turned over. And that has been what's happened in the game for the Rockets. They turn the ball over at least three times, and now four. And effectively is a crushing spot in the game with 1:44 to go here. The Rockets turn it over, and I'll tell you, this was a great game. Could have gone either way, and the extra point being the difference, but it really, the extra point wasn't the difference.
No.
The extra point was, unfortunately, the Rockets not taking care of the ball.
It was the turnovers, definitely.
Turnovers will kill you, especially against a good team, and clearly these guys were very, very evenly matched, as the score will tell you, but the Rockets are going to have to look for a play. Oh, let's see. If you Drake it, you want to stack this thing up and maybe run the clock out if you can.
Go for the strip.
In motion, number 24. He's been great for them. Oh, it's a direct snap up the middle, number 41. He rips it for a quick 12. So Pollock and Damari make the tackle there. But tell you, what a big change at the end of the game here. You're happy to have the ball back with 2 minutes and a great run back by Troy. And unfortunately, that toss is a little bit too high for Danny Damari and turn the ball over again. Couple of real fortunate bounces for Drake it to land on some. And then when they were going in, they had a fumble and they also got that ball too. So, definitely the fumble game has benefited Drake it here today. And we're running down with just a minute to go here, and this could be a brutal, just a really, it's not a disheartening loss, but it's, Rockets definitely in many ways in this game, maybe even defensively, might have been the better team here tonight, but we're running out of time. It's keeper for number 12. Get the ball. They got to go for that ball.
Oh, it's out.
He does get the ball. He does get the ball, but, oh, boy, he blumps in the air, and I think it might be back to Drake it.
Boy, if Drake it got that ball.
Oh,
they call
gosh,
him down by contact.
Down. Oh, boy. He certainly wasn't down. He was on his feet when he stripped the ball.
What?
And he is saying they're going to talk about it here and see what happened. He certainly wasn't down. Let's see what the call is. Boy, I don't even know what this call is. He's explaining something, but it looks like it's they still keep the ball there. Troy went in and stripped the ball. They said that he's trying to confer. We'll see what the call is. Ball was down a lot earlier, actually, than what we thought. So we'll have to look at that one on film. But once again, the bounce is not really going Redding's way, are they? Right? You know, you don't want to win a game on a turnover battle here, but this has been a great game. And look for Drakey. We're talking about Buffalo wings, right? What do you think, Patty? I mean, around here, I think Kitty's is pretty good.
Yeah,
we get the A squad up here. I know. Listen, Adam Lee Hook is new to the area, so he's probably saw some real Buffalo wings down in Georgia. But these guys, listen, I'm looking at Blumenshine and Adam Lee Hook right here. These guys could probably put away some Buffalo wings. Holy cripe, they're huge. Hey, listen, to this one, they have what they call the Wing Bowl in Philadelphia.
Yes.
One guy this year ate 444 wings in 26 minutes. Second place was a woman, 440.
The Black Widow?
Was that awesome? It wasn't the Black Widow. I forget her name. It wasn't the Black Widow. Who do you think on this team could eat the most Buffalo wings? I'm thinking Fleming, certainly. Maybe one. Danny O'Connor says Coach Blumenshine here. We got Adam Demers. That guy can eat. How about Patrick DeRoss? His favorite place is the fridge, right? So, listen. Here we go. We have 40 seconds left to go in this game, and I think Drake would be content. The Rockets are going to need a strip and a probably a miracle play to pull this one out today, but what a game. Right there was number 21, Richmond. Bunch of guys hop in afterwards. Becky and Hugh Soke and Stevie Needham. It's going to be third down here. I don't know what they have for timeouts. Have they called a timeout here? Coach Junta desperately trying to get the ball back here if he can, but certainly four down territory here. I don't know if there's enough time. If there's too few seconds on the clock here. Here we are, third down, and call it eight and a half here. 37 seconds to go in the game. Direct snap to 24. He's going to get outside. Edge. He's got all sorts of room in front of him. He cuts back, and he just hops in the ball. Smart play
Very
by that kid.
Play.
Stays in bounds. That is a really heads-up play for a little guy just chicken clock off here. He runs out of bounds. He stops it. And that is a great play by number 24. So, well-coached team, right? Well-coached team on both sides. And we're seeing it. And I'll tell you, last week's game versus Wakefield was awesome. This week's game versus Drake, it was awesome. Very well-positioned. And never mind that, how about the Rockets playing this way without Stephen Webb and Dante Barboza, two of the biggest athletes. And they play like champs out here today. I think you're going to see him kneel on the ball here, and it looks like that's going to be the game. The clock is running out as we speak. And unfortunately, I'll tell you, the Rockets are going to lose a tight one here. 7-6. That's a tough, tough loss there for the Rockets. But what a well-played game. And, you know, the difference was the turnovers.
Turnovers,
that's simple.
Absolutely.
The turnovers, the ball got put in the ground too many times. And, fortunately for Drake, they picked them up more than the Rockets did. And that made the difference in the game. So, hey, listen, next week we're actually on the road for 3 weeks in a row coming up. I think we're up in Chelmsford next week. But Rockets look to get back on. That's the first loss of the year for Reading. They go to 3-1. Drake goes to 4-0. And wouldn't it be great to see these guys again later? Oh, it'd be absolutely awesome. Oh, yeah, and by the way, and then bring Webb and Barboza with you, too.
Oh,
and say, oh, they sweat a little bit different team. But the Rockets look great. The D was awesome all day. And credit Drake, too. They were awesome as well. They get some big guys. And I can't wait to see that rematch. So once again, we'll sign off here, and we'll let the A squad come in. And we'll see you next week.